मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द एसे ऑफ आयोडीन। सो सिंस आयोडीन इज ए टाइप ऑफ रिडॉक्स टाइट्रेशन इन विच वी आर यूजिंग स्टार्च एज द इंडिकेटर, सो व्हाट इज द प्रोसीजर फॉर दैट? वी विल टेक सोडियम थायोसल्फेट इन द ब्यूरेट। Why? Because the normality of sodium thiosulfate is already known to you. We already know the normality of sodium thiosulfate, so it will be taken in the burette, and in the iodine flask we will take iodine, potassium iodide, water. We will add 1 ml of glacial acetic acid to provide the acidic medium. And 50 ml of water. After addition of all these things, we'll get pale yellow color. Remember one thing, we have not added any indicator till now. So when we will get the pale yellow color, then we will add the starch as the indicator. We'll take 2 ml of starch. So when after addition of starch as indicator, we will again titrate with sodium thiosulfate, which will give us blue color. Initially the blue color, and the color will change from blue to colorless. This is the main procedure. And what is the theory behind this titration is that sodium thiosulfate, which is present in the burette, will react with iodine, which will be generated in the conical flask with the addition of all these components. Both of these will react together to give you sodium tetrathionate, which is the final product of this chemical reaction, and this will give you the colorless complex. After the addition of colorless complex, we can calculate the percentage purity of iodine since we are doing the assay of iodine. You very well know whenever there is assay of something, that means we have to calculate the percentage purity. We will apply this formula, which is V. V stands for volume of sodium thiosulfate, which was taken in the burette. We will take the mean of 3 readings. That will be our volume of sodium thiosulfate consumed. M is the normality of sodium thiosulfate. Then this is the factor of iodine, which will come from the molecular weight. 0.1 into W. W is the weight of iodine, which you have taken in the iodine flask, that is 0.2 gram. So from this formula you can calculate the percentage purity of iodine. Thank you so much. So good afternoon students. Today we will do the titration of iodine with sodium thiosulfate. In the burette we have taken sodium thiosulfate because it is a standard titrant. The normality of it is already known. So titrant is always taken in the burette. So in this iodine flask, we have added iodine and potassium iodide. We will add glacial acetic acid to provide the acidic medium. And we will add some water. See, we have got pale yellow color. So now we will start the titration. We will add the indicator. In all the iodine titrations, we will add the starch as the indicator. So as soon as we have added the starch, you have seen the color change, which is blue color. You have read in all your previous classes. passes that whenever there is an iodine and whenever we will add iodine with starch, we will always get the blue color. So now we'll see what color we get after titration with sodium thiosulfate. See, it has become colorless. So the end point is blue to colorless in the assay of iodine. Thank you so much.